Hey guys, it's Mikexingchen. We have science to thank for a great many things. I mean, new discoveries are made all the time, and many of which largely contribute to modern society's technological progress. It has also helped in slowly unraveling the mysteries of life in the evolving universe. However, not all inventions created by man had mankind's best interest at heart. For example, some scientific pursuits have been explored simply to satisfy human curiosity, even at the expense of, well, the rest of the world. Nevertheless, scientists' tendency to fiddle with forces beyond their control have made them willing to face such catastrophic consequences all in the name of science. So in this video, we're gonna talk about six science experiments that could have destroyed the world. Number one, the tsunami bomb. This is a top secret operation codenamed Project Seal and was uncovered by author Ray Waru in the military documents hidden in the National Archives of New Zealand, and it involved a collaborative project with the US to develop a tsunami bomb that could wipe out coastal cities. And during the Second World War, the two countries covertly carried out tests by unleashing bombs underwater near Auckland and in New Caledonia, which they theorized could trigger tidal waves on a massive scale. Around 3,700 bombs were launched in June of 1944, and the tests revealed that creating a 33-foot tsunami was feasible by orchestrating a series of large offshore explosions. This project was shelved in 1945 as experts realized that they would need to produce around 2 million kilograms of explosives and strategically place them in a line several miles away from shore in order for a tsunami to potentially form. Number two, Operation Cyrus. This project was a collab between the GE Corporation, the Office of Naval Research, and the US Air Force, and their objective could have been really useful this year and was to experiment on the possibility of diverting the path of hurricanes. The first attempt to test this theory was made on October 13, 1947. At the time, a hurricane was headed eastward into the Atlantic Ocean. Project Cyrus sent an airplane to fly in close proximity to the hurricane, and the plane released around 180 pounds of dry ice into the clouds. Unfortunately, the hurricane switched directions and made landfall in Georgia, killing one person and causing more than $200 million in damages. The government initially denied seeding the hurricane, but officials eventually had to admit to the truth. The US government ended up signing the UN's Environmental Modification Convention, renouncing the use of climate or weather modification methods for potentially harmful and hostile purposes. Next, and I mentioned this before in previous videos, the Kola Peninsula borehole. Okay, the main objective of this drilling project conducted by the Soviet Union and its scientists was to drill as deep as they could on the Kola Peninsula in order to penetrate the Earth's crust. Drilling commenced in 1970 and it reached over 40,000 feet in 1989, making it the deepest artificial point on the planet. The project eventually had to be abandoned at around 8 miles because the machinery drilling the Earth was no longer able to function at, well, 300 degrees Celsius. While the project was ongoing, many have raised concerns over the possibility that the hole would trigger a colossal seismic disaster, with some researchers speculating that the seismic event that could occur would be massive enough to destroy our Earth as we know it. Also, while they were drilling, a lot of researchers reported hearing the sounds of screaming from people in anguish, and many of them believed that the screams were coming from the depths of hell, which they were getting close to. Number four, Projects Mercury and Volcano. From 1987 until 1992, the Soviet Union secretly detonated its nuclear weapons underground with the main goal of, well, manipulating electromagnetic fields and setting off earthquakes that shifted tectonic plates. These Soviet programs were known as Project Mercury and Project Volcano. Three of the tests were conducted in Kyrgyzstan, while the last test for Project Volcano reportedly took place in 1992. The 1978 Convention on the Prohibition of Military or Any Other Hostile Use of Environmental modification techniques banned these kinds of experiments, but attempts of developing a tectonic weapon is believed by some to be a secret ongoing endeavor by many government agencies until even today. Next, Starfish Prime. Sounds like a dish you might get at a seafood restaurant. But in the summer of 1962, the US government released and detonated a 1.45 megaton nuclear weapon around 250 miles into the space above the Pacific Ocean. This particular weapon had a force equivalent to around 100 times to that of the nuclear bomb that destroyed Hiroshima. The explosion unleashed a powerful energy pulse that affected various electrical circuits and power lines in Hawaii, which was about 600 miles away from where the bomb was detonated. It even disabled some of the low orbit satellites, and some of the experiment's effects remained felt 5 years after the explosion. As for the motivation behind launching Starfish Prime, the scientists were tasked to explore the possibility of whether Earth's magnetic field could be manipulated to serve defense and military purposes. Since then, treaties have been put in place to make sure that curious experiments of the same nature are prevented from happening in the future. Number 6. Soviet weaponizing the plague. In 1989, Soviet biologist Vladimir Artemovich Pashnik was the director of the Leningrad Institute of Ultra-Pure Biological Preparations. This turned out to be one of the front organizations for Moscow's covert biological warfare program called Biopreparat. According to Pashnik, he joined the project because he was initially promised that the civilian research operation was mainly focused on vaccine development. However, they ended up researching ways to release and spread the plague by modifying cruise missiles. They were successful in engineering an aerosolized version of the infectious bacterial disease, which could survive outside the laboratory and was resistant to various antibiotics. Now, of course, the plague, also known as the Black Death, caused the suffering and demise of an estimated 75 to 200 million individuals across Europe and Asia during the 14th century, which is why it is a bit terrifying to find out that a government institution even considered weaponizing a disease that could basically wipe out human life on the planet. But once the operation was brought to the public's attention, the Soviet government was quick to say in its defense that the research was not intended to be used as a bioweapon, but was really meant to contribute to the government's effort of engineering defenses against similar acts of biological warfare. And it was later revealed that the program had been discontinued. You know what? Anytime I hear about scientific experiments and research, especially concerning biological or technological warfare and military defenses, it kind of freaks me out a little bit. I mean, do we really have to go so far to kill each other? Don't we have enough weapons of destruction? When is this ever gonna stop? I mean, we just keep competing with each other to find better ways of killing each other. That's why I really feel this world, and I said this many times, I feel like this, we're really teetering on the end. And I feel like the UN is really just playing catch up. Oh, hey, you experimented with dolphins that could destroy the world. Hey, we're gonna sign a treaty that says no more of that. And then the next year, oh, hey, you're messing with tornadoes now? Yeah, we gotta stop that as well. I mean, will this ever end? Also, these are just the things that we found out about. Imagine all the secret operations, the Operation Unicorns, where leprechauns, where God knows what else the governments are hiding from us, and just all in the name of defense and keeping us safe, apparently. But anyway, let me know your thoughts on this topic. Thank you all so much for watching. See you later.